Hey everybody, Happy New Year, welcome back. My name is Sarah and it's been a while since I posted a video, but it's one of my favorites and I think it's one of your favorites to watch too. I have a packaging video for you. Today I'm going to package up some items that were requested by you guys in the comments. If you haven't seen my other videos, make sure to check those out. I will put them in the description box for you. I think I have a playlist of them. So you guys requested a bath bomb, earrings, scrunchie, and an embroidery hoop. So we're gonna try and make all of those items look really cool when you ship them out and hopefully think outside of the box, because I know something like earrings and scrunchie obviously are really popular and there's definitely very easy common ways to package them. So I'm gonna try my best to show you something that's a little bit different and that still kind of shows your brand and also is easy and affordable to do, because that's kind of always the theme of my videos. Not only am I gonna show you how to package these items to put in your shipping, but I'm gonna show you a couple ideas for actually shipping and putting them into shipping containers. I think when you put your items into a box or a mailer, it's also a great opportunity to brand it, stand out from the other packages. When someone opens a package, it's definitely an experience, and we know this because there's tons of unboxing videos and tons of people sharing really cool packaging on TikTok and Pinterest. So if you can make an impression, I think that does mean a lot, because you just get shared and shared and then you reach more people. I have a few examples, well, two examples. One is a box where I designed all four sides and it's from Packlane. The box is made out of 100% recycled materials, which is amazing. And it's really easy to design. They give you all of the guidelines. And their customer service was really great. I did work with them. They aren't sponsoring this video, but they did send me the boxes to try out. Same goes for the bubble mailer that I'm gonna show you, which is from Tishwish. You can customize the front of it and the mailer is compostable. It also comes in a few colors. So if you wanna see how to package those items, just keep on watching. Okay, first up we have our embroidery hoop. This was a hoop I got custom made from somebody I know on Facebook, so I'll make sure to put her Instagram handle. It's really cute, black on black, and has like a skull floral theme. Anyway, to do this you're gonna wanna use some paper. You could use newspaper, tissue paper. I'm gonna be using this recycled kind of craft paper. This is just from some packages that I ordered. So I have this for my own packages, so I figured I might as well use that. But I think newspaper would give it a really cool look. So I'm just going to fold this. You could get creative with how you fold it and to make it look a little nicer, you could use double-sided tape instead of this scotch tape, which kind of, I guess, doesn't look the nicest, but probably nobody's gonna care. And then you also wanna use some sort of twine, or this other black one is waxed thread. So something that is substantial, but also that fits with your brand. So for Return to Sender Co., which is my Etsy store, the black and craft is usually my kind of brand look. So I have lots of that kind of style of stuff ready to use. So I'm just going to tie this kind of like a package, but I didn't tie a knot at the top. I just kind of held it in place. And I have some dried florals, so you could use anything. You could go out and find some florals. I ordered these from an Etsy store for some resin projects that I was doing. But I'm gonna use that long, I think, I don't know, it's not a thistle, I forget what it's called, but I'm gonna use that. I put a piece of parchment paper in between the craft paper and the twine. And then I'm using some wax in a glue gun so I could do a wax seal on top. This is really easy to do and is so quick, but it looks so luxurious and it looks like you put so much effort into it. You can get custom wax seals done. This one I actually just got off Amazon. It's just the letter S. So, you know, if you want, you could get just a letter that stands for your business, but you could also get them made with your logo. Once it has dried, you can kind of touch around the edges to see. This is what it looks like, and it keeps the flower in place, and I cut off the ends. I didn't do a great job. You could probably cut off a little bit more, but I just think it wraps up the package so nicely. And for something like an embroidery hoop that probably took many hours to make, it's just kind of makes it look a little bit more elevated and like you put time and thought into the packaging. This is just an example of what else you could do. So you could use clear. I'm using just a regular glue stick. I don't know if they have clear wax sticks. They probably do. But this, doing it this way, you can see the flower underneath. So I just used a flower that would kind of fit in that circle. And so once you take that off, it's a little bit harder with the actual glue rather than the wax seal stuff. But that's what it looks like. And it's also a really cute look because you can see it through the clear glue. Another idea for embroidery hoops, I have this review someone left on my Etsy store. They do embroidery, and they basically used a fabric ink with one of my stamps to stamp on a label and then sewed that to the back of their padding for their embroidery. I thought that was a really cool idea and just thought I'd share with you guys. Next up is a scrunchie. I tried really hard to think outside of the box for a scrunchie. There's lots of ideas on how you can package scrunchies, and they're all pretty inexpensive. A scrunchie is usually not super expensive, so you don't want to spend too much time on your packaging. So I'm doing something that's a little bit different, but probably not too out of this world. I'm using some canvas material that I have, and I'm going to cut it into a long strip. To make sure that I get a straight line, I'm going to use my cutting board. I forget what that's called. And I'm also going to use a rotary cutter. These things are a must-have for crafting. They just cut fabric so much better than scissors. So I'm using that to cut along my scissor to make sure that it's a straight line. And then what I'm going to do is fold that over the scrunchie. So I feel like this is just maybe a little bit nicer than a cardstock one. And you can brand it by stamping with fabric ink. So you can grab these stamps from my Etsy store with your own logo. The store is called Return to Sender Co., which is what I'm stamping on this fabric right now. So the fabric ink is nice because it won't bleed on the fabric. And also if this happens to get wet, it's again going to stay put. So I'm just folding this over. I could have probably made this a bit longer to fit my logo better. You can also keep this shut by doing a small seam across, or if you want to be really quick and this does just as good of a job pretty much, you can just close it with glue, hot glue. So I did that to just close the end, and I'm fine with leaving a raw edge because I think it looks nice. And I don't want to spend too much time on my packaging when the item is not a large ticket item. However, if you do want to take this one step further, you could buy one of these like canvas kind of muslin cloth bags. You could buy blank ones off Amazon, and then you can stamp your logo on the front just like I did for the tag. And I think this kind of does give it a little bit more of a luxurious feel. So if you did have a more luxurious scrunchie, like maybe 100% silk one or even this velvet one, it does make it look a little bit more expensive. Okay, next up we have good old earrings. So I'm going to use a little velvet pouch. This is an example I used for my ornaments from my other Etsy store, and I used matte black vinyl on a velvet pouch that I got from Amazon, which I'll link below. But I'm going to try using these two because I got these while I was at Hobby Lobby. I just couldn't resist. So I'm going to try those. I'm just going to do a fast little transition because I don't need to show you how to iron these on. I'm sure you've done it before. So there you go. I'm all done with ironing those on. The leopard was super easy and the galaxy one was much more difficult to adhere. But I think they look really cool, and I think it's a cool way to put your brand on something in an inexpensive way, especially if you aren't doing super large quantities, if you're just a small startup. The velvet pouches are pretty inexpensive and you can get a lot of little logos out of one roll of this iron-on. So for the earrings, I stuck them on this holographic cardstock that I got from Michaels just as a way to display them. You could put a sticker on here, or you could use your own cardstock, whatever. It's just a way to
basically have your earrings stay in one place. So I'm using this to put in the velvet pouch, and then I'm just gonna fold the top and bottom of the velvet pouch. It's kind of the size of the cardstock. And then I'm going to neatly put that inside of a box. And I think this looks cool. I know the box is pretty standard, but usually you just have a card inside the box. And I think then there's a little pouch for the customer to keep their earrings in, because I usually don't keep the boxes that my jewelry comes in. Another option for a envelope that would fit into like a post box, so a thinner envelope, is using something like these hollow Ziploc bags. They are cute, and I probably wouldn't do like the hollow cardstock in here, maybe like a white one with a really cool sticker for your branding, or you could print it, but this would fit nicely and probably work for a more inexpensive pair. Also, the branding options are endless for these. Okay, so last we have a bath bomb. And I'm using one of the techniques you've probably seen in other videos, where I'm customizing a print by creating my own kind of stamp. This is what you would call like a lino cut or lino print. I'm using this linoleum like rubber, and I just drew a heart on it for the sake of this, just something really simple that I could draw and carve out quickly. And I'm carving out all of the rubber around it, and then leaving what I want to be printed raised. Actually, the death moth to the right was also carved out of linoleum, and it was definitely more intensive. So after you have those carved out, you can just roll on your ink and then stamp it wherever you like. I'm using an old pillowcase for this, but you could get pretty creative with your fabric colors. It's a great opportunity to upcycle. Like I said, I'm using an old pillowcase. So if you have some old fabric, you could do this. Maybe an old bandana, you could do a print over that. The options are pretty endless. You just have to think outside of the box and think creatively. But once you have a print that you like, you're just gonna let it dry. So I let this dry overnight, and then I cut it into a square. So I don't have a bath bomb at home, so I'm using this dryer ball. It's a wool ball, it's kind of the same size. And I'm just gonna wrap the square cloth around it. I'm trying to wrap it nicely, so I don't know if I did a good job, but again, you can figure out a way that makes you happy. And once I have that all wrapped up, I'm using some ribbon. I got this ribbon from Michaels. It's a leopard print ribbon, and I just thought it was really cute. But you could definitely match your brand with this. So you could get like a colored ribbon that fits your brand. You could even get a printed ribbon. Like you could stamp your logo on the ribbon, or you could order ribbon with your logo printed on it. And then I just tied that around the bath bomb. It's kind of like a gift basket now. And I just put it into a bow. You could also put like an elastic band on before the ribbon, just to make your life easier if you're doing a whole bunch of these. You could also use tissue or paper if you don't want to use fabric, if it's too expensive. So you just have to think creatively. You could also add a tag if you want to throw your logo in somewhere. I just use these that I cut and drew using my Cricut. And you can attach them with string or the ribbon, whatever you want. So these are all my items, all finished and ready to package. So I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna actually ship them. So the scrunchie and the box of earrings, they can fit into this padded mailer. This is the one I showed you at the beginning from Tish Wish. It is 100% compostable, and you can brand it. And then this is the back. It tells you what it's made out of. I put this design on where I have a spot for a name, because I always put people's names on their packages. So it just kind of incorporated it into the design. So if you wanted to do that as well, you just need to incorporate it into your design and upload that to the Tish Wish website. It has two sticky spots, so it stays closed pretty well. No worries about this coming undone. And it comes in a few colors as well. So for my other two items, I can put those in a box. The embroidery hoop I could probably put in a mailer, but I probably want to give it a little bit more protection. So I'm using the box that I made with the Packlane website. As you can see, I put my logo on one side and then I put kind of a pattern of stamps on the other. These are also made of 100% recycled materials, so that's great. So this is my package ready to go. I'm always really excited with how this looks and I'm really proud to send them out.
So I hope you enjoyed the video and that it gave you some creative inspiration to start thinking about packaging for your own items. If you want any more inspiration, make sure to check out my Pinterest because I have a board with all of the ideas that I see on Pinterest. And then I also encourage you to check out my Instagram and TikTok because I tend to post some of the packaging that I do for my own Etsy shops on those platforms. If you have any more ideas for shipping items or products that you don't know how to ship or maybe want some outside box thinking, just let me know in the comments below and I'll see you next time.